housing developments, they're an issue for villages, towns and cities all across the UK. Chinnor was once a relatively average-sized village with plenty of amenities for all of the community. However, in the past 5 years, there has been some dramatic changes in the village with rapid housing developments. In this documentary, we will be exploring the current issues surrounding the rapid plans to expand the village of Chinnor and the impact they have on the community. How have recent housing developments in the village of Chinnor impacted the community as a whole? Before discovering how far Chinnor has come, we must first look where it all began. Since 1932, a mass expansion has occurred and the population has inflated. The Chinnor cement works in 1957 led to houses being built along the Icknield Way, Tame Road, Church Street and Oakley Road. Since the 19th century, the population of Chinnor has risen from 862 to 1,467 in 1951. Rapid expansion can cause an increase in traffic, queuing and waiting times in various facilities in the village. During a study, it was discovered that 81% of participants thought that there had been an increase in traffic over the past 5 years. 53% agreed that queuing times in local shops have increased in that time. As well as this, 72% thought waiting times at their doctor's surgeries have increased. To gain first-hand experience, Derek Luxford gives his opinions as the manager of the Chinnor Village Centre about how the housing developments have affected the community.
The Chinnor Village Centre has been established since the 29th of November 1993. In the last 12 months it's pretty much on an even keel with the previous years. The coffee shop is constantly saying no to groups of people who want to bring different groups of people here on certain days, like 15 or 20 people, which we simply can't cater for. We have quite a few negative comments about Kiln Lakes and the type of person that was living there. There certainly has been problems in the village that I'm aware of with certain families that were moved in from the Britwell estate at Slough and other estates. Those people have now gone and everything seems to have quieted down, but the image of Kiln Lakes is still the same. I don't think that's justified, to be honest. Overall, a negative response. I mean, they always talk about Chinnor as a village. I don't see it now as a village as such. I mean, I've been here since 1984, and it just continues to grow and grow and grow, and it's a small town, really.
Quoting from Derek, Chinnor continues to grow and grow and grow. It's a small town, really. So what makes him think Chinnor is a town? Well, its rapid expansion could be something to do with it. In 2013, the population was standing at around 5,400. Today, it is well over 8,000. Since 2012, the old Kiln Lakes have been a large development in Chinnor, with the proposal of over 250 homes, ranging between 2 and 6 bedrooms. Therefore, this saw a dramatic increase in the population overall. When residents were asked, 82% said they would not consider buying a property on the old Kiln Lakes site. 94% of these residents believe that there needs to be more shops, including a bakery, groceries, and car garages, put in place due to the recent expansion of the village. Pat Hayward is the chair of the parish council. I went to visit her at the council office to see how the council felt about the developments in Chinnor and the effects there have been.
I've been involved with Chinnor Parish Council for over 20 years now. Since 2012, there's roughly 384. That's counting in the new appeals that we've just had in. One that Taylor Wimpey owned and one that Senex owned. We went to appeal in May and in June of this year, and the results actually came through last week. And they decided on appeal that they would award those houses to Chinnor. I wouldn't say that there was a demand. There was a demand for some social housing, and also for housing that would suit our young people who were trying to get onto the housing ladder. There has been an increase in traffic for a number of reasons, and that is not just from traffic within Chinnor, but we are one of the main routes from perhaps Aylesbury or Risborough to the junction on the M40, and it comes through Chinnor. Obviously there's some from new housing. Every house creates new number of cars within the village. And yes, the doctors are always asked if they can manage more patients. OCC are asked if school requirements can be met. Also Thames Water and authorities such as that. I think, yes, community does talk. They're more aware of what development means to Chinnor, whereas we've perhaps been in a sleepy place before because we haven't had major development since really the 70s. When Old Kiln Lakes was first put forward for development, the residents in Chinnor were very much against it for a lot of reasons, actually, traffic. Also the position where Old Kiln Lakes is, they felt they would be apart from a village and it'd be hard for them to be part of the village. We found them a group of very friendly people. Whenever we're doing a project up there, they're always great to get involved, and they have been good to work with. What happened was that it was a social housing provider has its offices in Slough. And some of the people actually that moved here in the first place were moved from towns to a village. I myself came from just Surrey, from a town, but before that West London. We moved to Chinnor in the late 60s, and I thought I'd give it 2 years. We've been here ever since. I really think that what we need in Chinnor is to help us through this and to have large building programs throughout the country. It is never fair to put people in properties that haven't got the infrastructure to go with them. I think Chinnor is a very generous place, and they support the community.
As Pat references to the Old Kiln Lakes residents as them, there is still quite clearly a divide between these relatively new residents and the rest of the community. Not only this, but the council recognise these developments as socially challenging for the village, and the community must pull together to get through it. The Kiln Lakes is continually being developed, as well as new plans being put in place. Since the beginning of my filming, Chinnor has changed extraordinary amounts. The current development focus is on the garden centre site at the entrance of Chinnor from Tame. This site used to be an abandoned garden centre, then to a pile of rubble, and now exciting new properties are being erected between 2, 3 and 4 bedroom houses. The future is bright in terms of development of Chinnor, as the Greenwood Avenue site has been confirmed only last month to go ahead, which will hopefully close the gap between the Old Kiln Lakes and the original village. It is certainly clear from the village response that housing development is controversial for the community. However, they have adapted well to these changes, and in the future, perhaps Chinnor could become a town.